On the horizon comes Dobby's grave. Yeah. In the distance, we have seen it. We've got to get down the sand dunes, though, which could be spectacular. Could fail. But we found it. My shoes are full of friggin' sand. I am fuming. We have arrived at Sir Doblet's grave. Harry Potter. So Grace is going to pop a pebble down now. That's what you do here. Let's have a look at your pebble check.
Ta-da! And then on the other side.
Beautiful. Obviously the normal photo being taken. And he's going to pop a pebble down. All good.
Yep.
One pebble down. Woo! Dobby's crusty sock. A bit mad, I suppose. Harry Potter. I suppose it is a pretty big film, innit? To think like a year ago we were here, West Wales, and Gracie had no interest in Harry Potter at all. Obviously this was here, we had no idea. So obviously Harry Potter's come into our world. And now we've got to visit. Bit different. Nice little thing to do, I suppose. If you're a fan, I'm actually growing into a Harry Potter fan. With Florida, that helped, but we're going to Harry Potter World in Watford later on in the year, so I'm looking forward to that. So this is all part of the experience. Just down from Dobby's actual grave, I don't know if you can see that, there's more pebbles the people have put, so yeah, interesting. It's only like a 5 minute thing, you have a quick read of the stuff, have your photos taken, a bit morbid. But yeah, there's nowhere to eat here. So it's very much just a beach with a road. So we've brought a packed lunch with us. I'm not gonna review the packed lunch because Jane made it. So we're gonna sit on this random log that we found. I hope it's not like a film log. And people are gonna take photos of us on the log and have our dinner. So in a minute. So that's Dobby's grave done. It's only about a little 10-minute affair. You have some photos taken in that. So we had a bit of food on a log. It was a very tasty little picnic. There's not a lot here. It is literal beach. If I flick the camera around, you'll see there, that's the road where you're parking, all the way up there. Then you come down there. That's a lifeguard hut. So there's nowhere to like have a coffee or something to eat. If I was them, I would put like a little cafe up with Dobby merch. And then sell it, and I'll be all over that. So far, I would have bought a coffee, I would have bought a sarnie or a cake, and I would have bought some Dobby merch. Sort it out, innit? So yeah, we're just going to walk along this stream now to look at a stream. And then I suppose it's might as well go back because there's not a lot here to do. But it is very good. If you're a Harry Potter fan, come and visit Dobby's grave just to say you've been there. Represent the greatest football club of all time. United. Off she goes in disgust. So I've always struggled with beach holidays. I don't know if it's because I'm on the spectrum. I just can't do this boredom part. It's like, we even bought a seat last year so I could sit down and literally just sat on the seat. I felt, I don't know, just so vulnerable on the beach. Just sat there like bored. You can't see the iPad because the sun's too bright. So you can't read a book because it's all you're on Kindle. So yeah, beach is not for me. And to be fair, I've got away from that. And if they are planning to go to the beach tomorrow, which I think is the plan, I may nip off into Tenby or somewhere on myself because I prefer to look around little shops and stuff like that. So yeah, beach holidays are not for me, but that was good today because I've obviously Harry Potter and Dobby's grave, definitely one to come and see. I'll put a link in the description if I can find one. What I would say to find it, if you come down the little bit there, the little walkway there, you go past the lifeguard and you're looking at probably 3 sand dunes afterwards. Okay, so 3 sand dunes afterwards, because we didn't know, we didn't have a clue. Probably people have told me, I weren't listening. So yeah, so these guys are just kicking around in the water. I imagine then we're going to go back to the car and go back home. So see you soon. So how was seeing your grave, Dobby?
Found it very, very nice, sir. It was a great experience to see the grave. Obviously, it's not real because it's a film and you're currently talking to a cuddly toy. But no, it was good. It's a pity they didn't have any merch.
I agree. They should have had merch and coffee.
And coffee. And a sock. Master could have given Dobby a sock. But it was good.
So I do believe that we are coming back. I do believe we are coming back here next year. So if anyone's visited here, and there's more, because I'm sure there's a house somewhere. I'm sure they used a house or something. And it's around here somewhere. I don't know. I should have done more homework, really. But if anyone's been here, is there anywhere else we can have a look next time? We'll probably come like in June next year for Harry Potter. Let us know. But yeah, it's a lovely beach. Freshwater West. Dogs allowed on here, the same as Freshwater East. Freshwater East lets dogs, so does West. So that's really handy if you've got a dog. My mother-in-law didn't come today with Daisy because they wanted to walk down to Wiseman's Bridge because they haven't done that yet. So, but this would have been a good place to bring them. So, how was Dobby's grave?
Amazing! Woohoo! I loved it!
Yeah?
Yeah.
What do you think of this beach, you know, overall?
I love it. Oh, amazing little streams, much better than ours at home.
Yeah?
Love it! Oh, there's too many bugs. Other than that, great!
Oh, this is the house that we are staying in Stepaside, Kilgetty, near Wiseman's Bridge. So I just want to take you round and show you. This is the garden area. Three cars can fit in here. There's a little bit of an area over there. Tables, chairs, if you want to use them, and just that area there. So let's go in and check it out. Back door is the front door, so you come into the conservatory and you'll see we've got a big table there ready to have you eating. You've got a piano at the back, which is mental. There's also a TV there that's got Sky. It's only free view though, but it does a job at the end of the day. Nice big wooden table. I mean, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 people around that table, which is really good. Next room, you can go into the kitchen, decent sized kitchen to be fair. Pretty much your basics. The lights are absolutely horrendous. That looks really good on the camera, but they're not. There's an ice machine. If you want to keep some wine in there, you got your microwave, toaster, you're pretty much your basics. There's an air fryer though. Always supply with an air fryer, that's fantastic. Coming through. Utility room. This is where the fridge and the freezer is based. And then you've got a sink and your washing machine if you're going to be using that. And a downstairs toilet with a shower, which is quite unusual to be fair. Decent sized. And having a shower, that's pretty good to be fair. Pretty good to be fair. It's not unusual having a shower downstairs. So if we go the far side, obviously I showed you that piano. I don't do pianos. In the second part of the living area, you've got a pool table, which is fantastic. Terrible a pool I am, but it's been good to have a couple of games with Gracie. That's been a lot of fun. Bingo at the back there, but also loads of games underneath if you want to burn some time. Fantastic sofa. I've got to say, this is a seriously comfy sofa. A lot of cushions, just really soft. And the telly, as we said, free view, but it's a real nice area, the living area. So downstairs, really comfortable, can't complain. Let's go upstairs. So at the top of the stairs, you have the first double bedroom. Decent sized wardrobes to the left and a television. That's quite decent, you know, a decent room. Just down the hallway, that's where you got the two single beds. I suppose you've got the kids' room. Again, the same wardrobes as in that room. Little TV at the back there and two double beds, metal frames. Not bad, not bad. So we turn now here, straight back down to the corridor. See that little window area? All Gracie's toys. There's Dobby just by there, looking out to the garden. Just walking past the stairs, you have the upstairs bathroom. Again, a bit like downstairs, decent sized. To be fair. But this is a bath cum shower, this one, where the others are walk-ins. So, yeah, it's a decent size. Can't complain too much. Then into the master bedroom. Double bed. Wardrobes to the right. TV there, biggest telly there. Sky's in there as well, but again, it is free sat. And then you've got the bed. Now, we didn't nearly discover this, but obviously you've got the wardrobes there. And then you've got this lovely mirror, full-size mirror, show off your belly. Come into Narnia. It's actually an ensuite. Yeah, cheeky little ensuite in here. So you've got the shower, toilet, sink, everything you need, but it's tucked away. How cool is that? The only down point with this is when you go in, there's no handle. There's no handle. There's no handle. So I put my fingers at the top and just do it slowly until you get it and you don't clip your fingers. That's the only way to shut it. What's the price of handles? Just buy a handle. So that's the house. I'll pop the link down below. So if you guys are interested in this house, you can go onto the website and have a look at bookings and stuff like that. It is very, very nice, to be fair. A little bit dated. It's a very cold house as well. I haven't really figured out what's going on with the heating. There's no instructions for the heating. Like I said, it is a little bit dated. It's a little bit tired, but it's comfortable. It is very comfortable apart from the heat. The internet is absolutely diabolical. Absolutely diabolical. You'd be lucky if you can get onto a website, to be fair. So internet needs to be upgraded, at least if they want to make that better. And because we stream everything nowadays, I think it's quite important. Overall, it's a 7 out of 10. Decent position where we're at. You'll see all that on the map. Again, it's a comfortable house. It's not the best. Last year's was probably a 9, 8 or a 9. This is a 7. Would I come back here? Yeah, I can't see why not if I had to. But personally, I think getting somewhere in Saunders Foot, because there's no, you can walk down to Wiseman's Bridge, but you're looking about a 35-minute walk. If you were in Saunders Foot, you could walk literally probably down the hill and then you're in Saunders Foot Village. So for me, Saunders Foot's the way forward, but it's not a bad house at all. Very comfortable. Yeah, highly recommended, guys. So that's the end of our day. As you saw earlier, we went to Dobby's Grave in Freshwater West. Now I've done the little house tour. I'm not sure about tomorrow. I don't know if the guys want to go to Saunders Foot. I've got to make a decision then if I'm going to go to Tenby on my own to have a look around. I'm not sure yet. We'll see what the morning brings. But if I do anything, I'll be bringing you with us. So guys, hope you enjoyed. Like and subscribe. And we'll see you very soon. Ciao now.